Welcome, ladies and gentlemen,
to Vlogmas Day 23.
Oh, sorry.
23. I'm trying to show the hairline.
Yeah. Look at the hairline though. Squat. Cheek.
Can you deep the trim? No face, no case.
You're so clapped, so quiet.
No face, no case. Just pre the trim. Wait, can you even see it? Can you see the trim?
The trim is on flick.
Why, thank you. You little, my favourite little biscuit. Oh, look at you. Oh.
You're so thick.
Show them Colgates. Ooh.
They're not. I need to get my teeth whitened. If anyone wants to get
Wow. Guys, if anyone wants to offer services to Nissi,
teeth whitening services, please let me know. Because
I'm included now as well. From now on, there will be no deals given to Nissi where I'm left out.
Wow.
Wow,
people sent them. Make sure you go and check out my latest videos, guys. Wake up Wednesday, it's okay not to be okay. I don't know when this is even gonna come out, but
guys, follow our channel. We're live.
Cheers! Whoa, just waiting on you, isn't it? If you wanted to get it
together, go subscribe to our channel, it's out there, you know.
If you wanted to get it together, it would be.
The name of it is. I don't know who you're sending for.
I was sending for you, bro.
For your face, fam.
Brother. Bro, cuz. Also, shout out to you guys. I've hit 25k on Instagram, guys.
You can't see that.
Wait, it'll focus. 25k, guys, on Instagram. I love and appreciate you
and
all so much.
And it's
back
to door or not?
No, it will.
Guys, shout out to you. I've got 1.5k followers now.
Yes, babe. That's good. Back at it again on one extra. I've been here three times this year. I'm so happy and humbled, man. I'm grateful. I don't know what accent I'm trying to do there, but I'm very grateful, man. Back again with Reese, the legend himself. Natural is back. Too dumb, but yeah, it's...
Why am I looking at the screen here?
I don't know, but it's Vlogmas Day 23, guys. I cannot believe it. We've done so well, apart from when the devil tried it a little bit. Broke my laptop charger. But it's cool, I ain't mad.
Why are you doing?
Because I'm talking to the devil right now. You ain't gonna get me down.
Loser. Okopola. Okopola kakaka. Diable opola kakaka.
Oh, okay. I was about to say, I thought you meant me. I was gonna say, what?
Diable.
I know, I heard after. That's why I said, what?
Okopola.
This is what I'm doing on the devil.
Okopola kakaka.
What did you do?
You know that look that Adrian and Omar gave that B money girl.
That's actually the look. But anyway, yeah, it's lit, guys. Spending day 23 here. I'm just waiting for Reese.
Yeah,
to
same.
Come.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
They want to see me now.
Okay, cool. They don't want to see you.
They do.
Oh.
So, guys, send in your questions. Thank you.
Hey. Still act like we're broke. Where's your pinky, babe? What happened?
I misplaced it again. I'll find it again in like 6 months. You know, there's that word.
Now you're not
tongue.
Verset biblique.
Biblique. So you boy be Bible. Verset dans la tongue. Bino. Is that verset moko mutuya? Nissi chanterait.
Wow, verset mon quoi?
Et ça verset mutuya. Parce que, what does that mean?
Verset mon quoi mutuya?
Yes, verset mon quoi mutuya. Verset dans une tanga, c'est quoi?
Okay, the verse that I want to read right now is a verse that is fire.
What's mutuya?
It's like lit. It's really good. It's hard.
Nope.
It's like the top best
verse. It's like very educational. It's very like deep.
In what? Kikongo?
No, Lingala. Mutuya. That line was nasty.
I don't know about this one.
Here. So, those of you who speak Lingala, please give me your definition of what Mutuya is.
It means nothing.
And meaning, and in a...
Hey guys. Leather jacket number one, leather jacket number two.
Okay. I'm ready.
I'm just going to go to the toilet.
We're
about to lock
okay,
in.
Go on.
I'm like Nikita, I drink 4 litres of water a day.
Wow.
Looking healthy.
That's what I need in my life. I need to be that.
How can you sound like that?
So you guys are seeing behind the scenes.
What am I doing? Look at this. Smart.
My three. Missy T, I need some levels, please.
Alright, take yourself in. So you've done radio before, but obviously we no swearing of any sort. No mentioning any brands, bad mouthing brands. No,
your phone, silent.
Just being creative, but you know, yeah.
Right, that
works. So, Reese.
You just count to 10 quickly for me. Just okay. Double check that.
1, 2, 3.
Yeah, that's all good.
You're gonna be five.
Cash hound me. Does that mean run through the snow? With the one and only. Oh my gosh. It's Reese Parkinson.
Dun, dun, dun.
In the music. Dun, dun, dun.
Tune in.
Make sure you lock in, guys. Let me know if you're locked in as well. Different way. It's a bit awkward, a bit weird. It's a little bit long as well. Okay, so would you rather lick your favorite rapper's belly button?
P&B Rock.
Wait. Belly button every day for 1 mil, or lick between your favorite singer's toes after a long day for 5k a month? So either belly button, favorite rapper, or toes, and it's after a long day, like
when,
a day of
when you
work.
Get that Stilton type smell from the cheese, isn't it? That's brie smell.
And you know it's a bit funky, a bit stale.
And if they don't wear, are they wearing socks or not?
No socks.
Okay, I'm licking belly buttons.
Licking belly button.
Easy. The one extra resident DJ. Oh. Would you rather bathe in vomit or bathe in poo?
For what?
Or there's no money involved.
No, either. There has to be some sort of money involved because you can't have me doing that.
No.
For no reason. But I think that's disgusting. I think the vomit, but then the vomit will make me want to vomit. That's not gonna help.
Right, last one for you, Nissy. Let's...
Right, so Nissy misbehaved, so we're getting kicked out.
How do
we need to go this way?
Oh, this way, no worries. Oh, okay.
So can you go the other side because you're like next to the road?
Oh. Yeah,
so yeah.
Me all the time. Won't let me walk next to the road. Real gentleman, eh? Look at you.
No, obviously I just did that for the camera, innit? So
obviously,
I can get some
just acting, innit?
Yeah. No, we just got kicked out because Nissy was misbehaving, so.
I was not misbehaving. Byron!
I've still got this one.
Huh?
Still got my BBC One Extra thing.
Tag on. And today I don't feel that short because I'm wearing heels. My boots.
I know already.
Very happy. Do you want some gum?
Yeah, I do. Are you trying to set my breast smell?
Yeah.
Don't know. Before I take your nanas, I'm going to make you watch me eat.
Wow, that's mean, babe. You
know what I mean?
Here you go.
Because we know how Nissy gets.
Funny. Ben just called me a crap vlogger. Do you guys think I'm a crap vlogger? I don't think I'm a crap vlogger.
She's always forgetting to get in the right spot. And I look hella dumb.
Because you're dumb. Don't put it in my ear because you... That's not funny. Yeah, then.
What the bitch? You got the shot. Squat down, hit the floor. Yeah, guys, my own personal.
Wow.
Get that. My very
that's
own personal.
That's my exercise for the month. Okay. Oh my gosh, that was a workout. Okay, I'm done. Did you zoom in?
Yeah, boy.
was my exercise for the month. It's done. Look at this guy. Look at this guy. He seems to think he's a dancer.
Trying to spend some money.
Trying to spend
some Nissi's money, you get me?
He's not spending any of that.
Finesse
you guys can't see, he can't spend any of
that. I'm trying to finesse Nissi's money. So they're distributing this fake snow.
Not all of us coordinate with this weather.
This fake snow.
This stuff. I don't really like helping out.
So. They want to be making it so cute,
yeah,
in there.
Yeah, I don't know where the hell they
can you imagine us, we're in Manhattan.
In there.
We're strolling through.
Lit. Talking of that, actually, we need to book our tickets.
You know, we're walking through the streets of Manhattan, you know.
No, London. London is still
Congo. The dust is blowing in our eyes.
You're so dumb. You're actually so stupid. But no, for real, they're really making it look like snow up here.
I hate the smell of smoke, man.
Okay, but babe, people smoke though.
If they want to smoke and block up their own pipes and lungs and all this stuff, I'm not interested.
I don't know how they're managing to do this, but well done, guys. They're probably making it look Christmassy.
Oh my god.
Hi. You all right?
Nice to meet you.
So, you know, what it happened was.
That's so nice. Shout out to Shanae.
I love your head, man. Look how your throat's on head. What it happened was.
Oh, babe, shoot, by the way. And I think I just saw it say beautiful.
You're going to be on our vlog, by the way, yeah?
I'm so done. Say hi to the vlog.
Hi, guys.
How are you?
I'm so good.
So what's his shoe shopping?
It's your birthday, my
birthday. Your afro is blocking her, you know, she wants to be in the place.
Sorry, the hair is a lie.
I'll stop filming. I'll start charging you for every time I film. So guys, I wanted to let you guys know that...
Can you imagine his trash behaviour?
In a relationship, you need to put your foot down. I've told Nissi that she's going to be purchasing me 2 pairs of trainers. And that is what's going to happen. Thank you.
See his life. Shambolic, absolute shambolic.
So,
someone come and collect him, please.
I'm about to purchase 2 trainers, and I'm not even spending any money.
He makes me feel sick.
Jeez! Nissi just gave me that young purchase again.
Yeah, this is for me, honey man.
She just bought me some, yeah, because you're size 11, yeah? She just bought me some, you know, some young boobs, you know. What boobs? Boobs. Trainers?
I don't know, what the hell are you talking about, honey?
You gangsters out there, tell me books is trainers.
Gangsters out there.
Yeah, you know.
Yeah, but I just...
You make your woman buy your shoes and then she carries the bag.
No. Finishing. Finishing, please. He's dumb. Finishing, please.
Yes.
Listen, they're just... Oh, is it her birthday or something? Happy birthday, love.
Yes, no, it's
probably.
You're gonna be on the vlog, B. You're gonna be live.
Look at that! Just look at. Oh, my lord. What happened? All of a sudden, bare people. Wants to do something really, really bad. He wants to turn up the music right there. He wants to just work it out.
Before we go up.
No.
The left-hand side. Change for the Circle and District line. Exit for Westminster Abbey and Houses of Parliament.
That's the quickest way to become single. Guys, it's been an eventful day. I'm so tired. Yeah, boy, I'm still
learning. He's so annoying. I can't not laugh. He's so annoying. So I'm contemplating, guys. I could go to work tonight.
Yeah, anyway.
Needs help.
Yeah, so she's not.
She needs help in the. She needs help on the strip club.
So. I've told Nissy that she can do anything that she wants to do. As long as she informs me that there's certain criteria which will deem her single. I think that's fair, right?
Like me being a stripper. Am I going to help
you do it?
Doors will open on the right-hand side.
It's not a club.
I'll be interested to see what my mate
and I can do some bartending to make some extra coin, you know? Next week, after this week is Christmas, so why not? Could do it today and tomorrow. You're going to work on Christmas? So what?
I'm going into an office.
Okay. I'm going to
call some
drinks.
Running.
Okay.
Exactly.
So what are you saying?
Do it. Let me see you do it. Do it. Let me see you do it.
Anyway, it's been an eventful day. I'm tired.
So that's why you're just chatting so much more. And she wasn't soaking on your own.
They're salting who?
I said soaking. But is it working
guys,
as well?
I swear, like, I just want to find my damn fans.
Yeah,
but
bare joy, bro.
Find them. Stop being annoying.
Is that good? Is that
no, but then why are you hitting me? He's so annoying. So.
The next station is.
I don't, guys. I really don't. We use Rasta kind of body lotion. Dudu Osan.
Guys,
you
listen.
You listen. I'm using Dudu Osan. My skin
uses Caro Lights.
Listen. I'm using black soap. My skin has been really good.
Sorry. When I'm talking to my family, don't interrupt. Alright guys, thank you for watching vlog day 23. Today's been a very good day. I spent the day with my queen, Missy.
Went radio. So moist, man. Wet bread. Anyway, did a bit of shop last minute into my shopping. Yeah, bear, because we're going to buy that in Boots. Anyway, and yeah, I might come back to you guys later on. Or not.
The next station is London Bridge. Doors will open on the right-hand side.
So it looks like it's going into my mouth. That is disgusting. Just breathe all over. Wow.
Where are we now?
Guys, pre his screensaver face. But babe, there's something going across my eyes.
Yeah, it's my software update pull-up, I think.
But go to your, eyes.
Oh, what am I doing?
One of my pretty pictures from this year. Oh, he's so cute.
I can't butters you.
Wow, I'm butters, yeah.
When finessing...
Graduation.
This is how you finesse girls,
babe,
guys.
It's gone off.
Guys, this is how you finesse girls.
Wow.
See? I'm doing pictures, everything. I'm still with her after a year.
Yeah.
trying to blow off Nissy. Don't know.
Yes. Hey guys, welcome to day
two, Vlogmas day 24.
I'm just block my face.
Come, Christmas Eve. Okay,
guys,
let's not
welcome
go.
Welcome back to
Christmas
Vlogmas day 24. Right now, we're just gonna go do some last minute Christmas shopping because tomorrow is Christmas day.
Yeah, it's truly last minute. This is day before type of Christmas shopping. Like, yeah, who even does that?
Tomorrow.
Yeah, I do this every single year.
Tomorrow
it's so
we're
bad.
We're gonna go to our cousin's house. That's why we need to pick up some stuff from Iceland.
Look at these people.
To get some food.
This car's coming. Go.
You know, we're gonna go and get some food. Just a few bits, so because tomorrow is Christmas, and obviously we're gonna spend it with family and friends.
My family is so crazy like this, like we own the damn store. Look at these people. Why do we have to get so excited? I knew it was mega. Do you know what? From afar, yeah. Oh, mega. Yeah. It's lit. Still gorgeous, girl. I don't know what you trying to do, but this is. Do you guys remember Christella? Yeah. She doesn't wear trainers ever. I barely ever wear trainers, but listen, it's Christmas Eve.
It's Christmas.
We're the last minute people doing our Christmas shopping.
People.
So we have to be about it right now. Right, see?
Mary, give us an update.
Well, that's up to you then. That's your fault.
Okay.
Not mine. Why do what?
Okay.
So far, what did you say?
When did you pull out the camera?
I literally just pulled it out just now. Anyway, point of the story is a little bit of an update. So we've done. People said, "Are you Nissy?" I was about to say, "How do you know me, fam? I don't know you." I'm so done. But yeah, we did all of our. We've done our shopping. Loads of food shopping. Bought all the food. Where's Sephora? Yeah, do you want to buy it now?
Yeah.
Okay. Anyway, point of the story is that I am going to be helping out at the Brixton Soup Kitchen today. And I need to be there for 3:00. We've just got a couple more bits and pieces to get. Should be on time, should be good. Right, come on. Wow.
I'm sorry. I don't know what to say. I'm so tired.
Sephora says that she's so hungry. Get food then.
With what money?
I gave you guys money.
And I suppose I've got a chance.
Right, well then sometimes in life you've got to sacrifice certain things. Sorry. Here, guys. Look at the sign. It's lit. Quick go.
Guys, thank you guys very much. So it's been absolutely manic, but guys, you can carry on supporting us. We're not open just in Christmas.
Yeah,
open all year round.
Mm-hmm.
So guys, make sure you come and check us, and please follow us for 2018.
There we go, everything in the description box. Hey guys, look who I bumped into. Well, that's a bad angle of you. Wow.
Jonathan, oh, yes.
You're gonna fall or drop the camera?
I've got balance. Yeah. But I'm just not trying to crease my shoes. So.
I believe in it now. Let me see.
Oh, the lighting is bad.
I thought there were two roadmaps.
The lighting is bad everywhere.
Are you walking flat footed?
Yeah. Right, guys, so.
Randomly,
we just saw Nissy on the underground.
Yep.
And I was just saying to her, imagine if I caught her slipping. Imagine if I saw one crusty guy with his arm go over your shoulder.
No, but what if it was just my mate?
No, you need. Would your mate be doing it if I was there? See, this is a question you need to ask. Would said person be doing the same thing in your presence?
Or would I allow them to do the same? Would be happy with them to be doing the same?
So don't be doing something that you wouldn't do.
No, 100%.
Saying,
I was just asking.
This is why I want a wife in this year.
Yeah. Oh.
I mean,
I was even talking about you, like my friend Naomi. What are you,
this bus is doing a lot today. Anytime anyone gets close to me, I'm like, I'm
Oh, your trainers.
Yeah.
So, let me just move my foot.
Can you film from the trainers? Get trainers.
The trainers that I bought you.
I was just going to say that.
Oh, sorry, sorry. Go and do it again. Say.
Yeah, it's cool.
Okay, well, let's go to the trainers that I bought him for Christmas. I got something else for him for Christmas, but couldn't find it, so I'm just going to order. Say hi, Jonathan.
That's what it was. Mama went.
I didn't even see what you did.
So, yes.
So, do you want to vlog or not?
Guys, so.
You're collecting the camera from my hand.
Jonathan, come in. So, this guy right here is my first son. Do you know what I mean? This is my son. What's your name, man?
What did he call him?
Huh? He went, I said, this is my son. And I said, what's your name? He goes, he's crumbling in front of the camera.
Nah.
What's your name then? So, how old are you?
You're gonna come to me.
18. 18. Alright. So, where can they get your snap?
Yes.
See, he's not about it. He doesn't want trouble.
Fashionista,
water, easy water,
fashion. Oh my gosh.
Biggest. Huh? Biggest.
Also, guys, I know that I just jumped, you know, to Betty's only because I bumped into him. But I'm going to tell you guys about what happened today. I know I didn't show you much because, yeah, I just didn't want to film stuff like that. You don't. Yeah, I'll talk to you guys later. Don't worry, we'll catch up. Hi. Hey guys, what is going on? What's poppin'? What's good? I don't know what's wrong with me, but anyway, as you can tell, I'm back home. My eyebrows look so clean. I got them done the other day. So yeah, they look super, super clean. But what was I gonna say? So, as you saw, randomly bumped into Ben and his cousin, Jonathan. It was so crazy how it happened. Like, literally, if I had decided to just do something like for 2 seconds more, we wouldn't have seen each other because the train was literally just coming and I saw him on the platform. It was so weird. But yeah, Ben was on the train actually going to my house, coming to mine, to drop off the gifts that he had bought for my family and also to pick up the gifts that I had for his family. So yeah, man, it was just so crazy the way everything happened. So yeah, we did that. We exchanged what we needed to exchange. I just had some dinner. And yeah, I'm like quite tired. Obviously, it's been quite a long day. So yeah, let me talk through what kind of happened today. As I mentioned to you before, I didn't film that much only because I literally film when I feel like, oh, I want to capture this moment, or oh, it's appropriate to capture this moment. I don't film when I feel it's inappropriate, which was, you know, when we were just giving out stuff to, like, the homeless people. So let me even explain from the beginning. So in case you don't really know, oh, let me delete some stuff and come back. Anyway, yeah, so as I was saying, so yeah, I went to go and help out at the Brixton Soup Kitchen. Obviously it's Christmas Eve, and you know, just in the lead up to like Christmas and stuff, just people are on the streets on their own. Some, you know, they don't have food, don't have whatever it is. So we literally, you know, went over there, packed up as much stuff as possible, from sleeping bags to hats and gloves and scarves and jumpers and food, just as much stuff as possible. And then people that had cars and stuff got into their cars. I was with a friend of mine who I bumped into there, Naomi, who's also a presenter and stuff actually. And yeah, we got into the car. And there was another group in another car, and we all went together. We went to Waterloo, and that was our area. And we basically gave out, you know, stuff to people on the streets. And it was the most, I have to say, it has been the most humbling experience probably of my life. And I know that sounds so cliche, you know, oh, somebody goes and does a bit of charity work, oh, they feel like, oh, they go and volunteer and they feel like, oh, so like upset by it, like, you know. But genuinely speaking, it was
so humbling. Like, it was hard, man, just seeing people, talking to people. It was tough. It was really tough. And there was this one particular guy, the last person that we spoke to, his name was Jimmy. He was from Ghana. Lovely guy, so nice. He had such a positive energy about him. He was just so positive. And it's getting me emotional when thinking about him. I don't know what it is about him. Like, I feel like, you know when you're just supposed to meet people in the world and they're supposed to make an impact on your life? Like, in like the 5, maybe 6 minutes that we were talking, he made a huge impact on my life. He was just so lovely. And you just look at someone and you think, how do you end up here? Do you know what I mean? We were just chatting and he was just being so nice. And then I saw him reading a book and I was like, oh, what are you reading? He was reading Roots. And he's like, yeah, it's an amazing book. It's a page turn. I'm thinking, oh my gosh, like, why are you here? And then we gave him obviously some stuff. And then as we were kind of like about to leave, he was just like, can you pray for me? When I say to you, I was like, of course, like, of course, if there's what. And the crazy thing is, like, I remember before I left, or I can't remember if it was before I left or as I was going to the soup kitchen, but I was like, God, like, I just want to pray with just one person today. And he literally said, can you pray for me? And I was just like, of course. And I prayed over this man, I prayed over his life, and he was just like, oh, I feel so much better. I feel good. I feel like, oh, I'm literally getting shivers. Like, I'm getting shivers just thinking about it. But it was such a humbling experience. And then I gave him like a hug. We hugged each other. Oh, I just, oh man, I don't even know how to describe it. But he, you know, he's like, I'm gonna be fine. Like, you know, I should be in accommodation really soon, and you know, tomorrow I've got somewhere I'm going to be going to. He's going to like another center where he'll have somewhere to stay, and he's going to have food and stuff for obviously for Christmas and all that kind of stuff. And so he was just so positive. I could not, like, I was just like, wow. But he was amazing, man. And I just pray like that God just allows everything to come together. I just pray, because you could tell he still had hope in his heart and he had faith. And I said, God, you say that you can do things with the faith of a mustard seed. A mustard seed can fit probably in between that little bit that I'm holding my finger together. That's how tiny a mustard seed is. And you know, in the Bible it talks about being able to move mountains with faith as little as a mustard seed. And his faith was definitely more than a mustard seed. So I just pray that God moves mountains for that man and that he can be so blessed. But yeah, Jimmy from Ghana, Jimmy in Waterloo, he had like dreads and stuff. Just, oh, my heart. Basically, my heart just, today was tough, like tough. And you know, obviously, those that also support and follow BEBB Online, which is the platform that I run with my team, Be Educated, Be Bold. We have an interview series, and we did an interview with Solomon, who is the guy behind Brixton Soup Kitchen. And I'm going to link it in the description box below. But it's BEBB Online, our YouTube channel, and it's season 1, episode 5, his interview is. And he spoke about this stuff, and he just said, you know, these are people that you walk past every single day. Every day, and you don't even notice them, but these are people who some had lives, some who were famous, some who were rich, and then it just all just disappeared. And yeah, I'm talking a lot right now, but today was an emotional day. And as soon as we finished praying with Jimmy, as soon as I got up and I turned around, I just started crying. Like, I tried really hard not to cry. I was like, I'm not gonna cry. And my friend Naomi was like, do you know what? I'm probably going to cry. I was like, listen, if you cry, you're going to trigger me. And then can you imagine? She's the one that said she was going to cry, and then I ended up crying. But it was just after that prayer, like, I just, oh, Jesus, Lord, help. But anyway, I'm getting very emotional, so I'm going to go now. But yeah, literally all I'm about to do now is, I've actually had my dinner. I'm watching Peaky Blinders.
yeah, this program is lit, guys. I started from the beginning, from season one. I'm on episode two now. The episodes are an hour long. They're freaking long, mate. I might watch some more tomorrow, but yeah, man, it was just amazing. It was beautiful, but so sad, but so beautiful at the same time. Sorry, I'm like switching in between Peaky Blinders and that, but yeah, today was an experience and a half. Like, I just honestly, guys, support what Bricks and Soup Kitchen are doing, because what they are doing is incredible. It is admirable, it's phenomenal. Whatever word you want to throw in there, it is all of that and so much more. They are so amazing, and they go above and beyond. They go above and beyond, and it's beautiful what they are doing. So please, I'm going to leave all of their links to their stuff in the description box below. And if you want to help, you want to volunteer, if there's anything you want to do, because they take people all year round. Remember, guys, this is one thing that Solomon said as well that was so important. Like, don't forget, homelessness is not just during Christmas. It happens all year round, so they always need help. So I'm going to leave all the information in the description box below. But yeah, I'm going to go because I've been talking for ages. Watching some Peaky Blinders, and then I am going to edit this vlog, and then while that's exporting, I have got my red wig. I've got a whole separate video that's gonna come out showing how I transformed my wig, but let me show you how it is looking right now. There's my wig right there. That was my blonde wig, it's now gone red. Yeah, it's now my red wig. And I cannot wait. I'm about to like blow dry it and style it and stuff. And then I'm probably gonna pop it on my head tonight so I can lay it flat so that I can be looking fleeky. Obviously it's Christmas tomorrow and I'm trying to look buff. My nails are did, got my nails done the other day, even though, look, this one's pinkier than the other ones. Don't know if you can tell, but it's pinkier than the other ones because of the hair dye, which is really annoying. But because the color is so similar, it doesn't look that bad, so it's fine. But yeah, man, thank you guys so much for watching. Tomorrow is Christmas Day. It has been amazing vlogging every single day. I actually think I could potentially be like a daily vlogger. I think I could do it, but my life isn't as, you know, interesting as other daily vloggers, but I potentially could do it because I've had fun like doing this. But I felt like I haven't been able to be as creative as I could be because I've just been kind of like, I just need to get out the content. I just need to get out the content. Not that I'm that massively creative. Anyway, waffle. I will see you guys tomorrow for Christmas, which is really, really exciting. But yeah, for Christmas. So bye, guys. Sleep well and see you guys tomorrow. Bye.